Los Robles.
Oh, yes, sir. Good feeling. Go Phillips there. Final one of five. Got 10 seconds on the Ward 24E. Just bad fix spring. He's the hottest thing in the country. Real hot and blue. Coming to you through WHBQ in Memphis, Tennessee. It's Friday night.
If you haven't guessed by now, you're on television, and so don't let the lights and cameras fool you. But they are hot.
Tomorrow night is Elvis night, as CBS invites you to see and hear Elvis in concert. Tomorrow at 8, 7 Central and Mountain.
Tomorrow night is Elvis night on CBS.
One little party in the county jail.
When you'll be able to see and hear Elvis's last concert, filmed in June of this year. Elvis in Concert, a presentation never before seen in theaters or on television. Elvis in Concert, tomorrow night at 8, 7 Central and Mountain Time.
There's a Dynamite Elvis Presley special coming up next.
That's right. But tune in tomorrow night for our kind of action on CBS.
CBS brings you highlights from Elvis Presley's last two concerts in a one-hour special tomorrow night at 8, 7 Central and Mountain on CBS.
The following program was recorded a few months ago, and it represents Elvis's last concert tour.
And we knew he had a good voice for singing, you know, because he did do a lot of singing, like in church. And he made his first public appearance when he was 9 years old. It was a school competition type thing, and he won a third prize singing Old Ship. And at that time, he couldn't even make no kind of music, you know, he just sung songs. One thing that was good, he never changed his feelings about people or about anything. You know. I'm sure he was very happy with his success and all the things that's happened to him, but good. But it didn't make him think he was something that he wouldn't, you know. I lived with him till my wife died in 1958, his mother, which we had been married for 27 years. And then in 1958, he went to Germany in service. I went over there with him. When we come back in 1960, I remarried. That's when I moved out of Graceland, and I haven't lived in Graceland since then. But I live, my land joined his. I live right at his back doors, so we're still together. I know he can't go out like an ordinary person, you know, because people see him and of course they recognize him and they worry about this and that. And there's been so many different news reports out that they've made him into a hermit type guy like Howard Hughes was supposed to be in. You know, I don't know how this stuff all gets started, but it's not really true. Elvis started in the latter part of 54, and he went through 55, was doing pretty good, you know, locally, Arkansas, Texas, Mississippi, just touring the country. Mm-hmm. Is where he met Colonel Parker. In 1955, Colonel Parker was booking shows down through Florida. He had people like Hank Snow, Marty Robbins, just a whole package deal of the Grand Ole Opry stars. So he booked Elvis with Act, you know. At that time, Elvis's manager was named Bob Neal. He was a disc jockey there in Memphis. So Elvis got to liking the Colonel, and the Colonel got to liking him. So that's where it started. Colonel Parker is an honest man, and I think that's where the big organization and the big togetherness comes, you know. Once you find out, you don't have to worry about a guy being your manager, what he's gonna do for you. He handles it, you do the show, and everything works well.
He is just the king.
The king.
He's the king.
The king of music.
King. He is the king.
He's the king, he's great. I love him.
He's the king.
He will always be the king, no matter what.
I think he's a good, clean fellow.
There's any auditorium in the country that has Elvis has an experience that he never forgets, and it's one of the attractions that every building looks for. When Colonel Parker gives you the call that you have a date, after all that, it's just like you're in the army, everything is done by the numbers. And the arrival time is always kept at a minimum. Only a few people know what time he arrives or what airport he'll arrive in. And from the time he hits the ground until the time he's on that stage would be roughly about 8 minutes. When you feel that burst of excitement, of the enthusiasm of the crowd, you just feel as though God just landed.
Many times. Touched the gate and everything. That just crazy. Turns me on just to do that. What's it going to do when I watch him tonight? They've got an ambulance waiting by.
If he said, come along, let's go, I wouldn't look back.
Imagine he'd still be as good looking as he always was. Just older.
Well, it's hard to be a gambler, betting on the number. It changes every time.
When I first knew him, he wasn't playing the type of music I like, but now I think it's just all tremendous.
Yes, I was in love with him.
Oh, he's such a sexy person.
I'm not a spring chicken anymore.
He's great.
Complicated lady, so call her my baby.
About Elvis and about how great he was when I was growing up. She has no idea who the man is. I think a kid can't grow up without knowing who Elvis Presley is.
We're retired people and all ages come to see him, I think.
I think it's a lot of the flashy clothes he wears and everything, and it seems like all women like that.
Well, when Monday comes, she's Tuesday. When Tuesday comes, she's Wednesday. To another day again. Her personality unwinds. It's like a ball of twine. On a swing of the
cars and all the rings, all the clothes, his quality. I mean, and I think he's a very religious person. I mean, very. But he's human. I mean, he cusses on stage. Well, that's human. I mean, but he's religious, like, he's nice to people. I mean, he's human.
Okay,
Check. 1, 2. Yeah, leave it up.
Oh, I'm so nervous, I can't stand it. He's so special and everything, and he's the best looking guy in the world.
This is about my 28th concert since 1972.
That was means to me, a legend.
He's honest. That's the main thing, he's honest. And he's got vibes, you know? And that's what we enjoy. This is my son, and he's been an Elvis fan since he's been 3 years old.
I give Elvis a lot of credit for bringing blues into rock and country. He's the first guy to ever do that, and I admire him for it. He has a lot of courage, and he's my number one. He's my number one singer of all time. Hope to name my kid after him someday.
I still live at home, and I have a fairly good job with the post office, and just about all the money that I do make goes for seeing the Elvis shows. But it's worth it. It's worth every penny of it.
I just love the guy. I mean, I know that sounds kind of weird, but I just love the guy, and I wish him many years of success.
I would say he is religious to the point where, of course, he can't go to church like many other people can every week, but you can see, by the way, he sings a lot of these spiritual songs, songs such as How Great Thou Art and From Time to Time You'll Never Walk Alone.
I have about four of his gospel albums, and my favorite is How Great Thou Art.
The official Elvis Presley fan club of Great Britain and the Commonwealth is probably the world's largest Elvis Presley fan club. We boast a membership in excess of 12,000 members, and that's a live membership. It's not one that we keep adding members to each year. Once each year, we bring a charter flight to the United States, and that's what we're doing here in Cincinnati today.
All the way to Scotland! All the way to Scotland!
I'm so excited, I could just... Oh, I can't wait!
Ladies and gentlemen, Elvis in concert!
Photo album with some 25 color portraits of Elvis and his concert tours across America. The giant photo album sells for only $3. And then we have the giant Elvis portrait on portrait paper. Looks just like an oil painting for only $5. We have the smaller Elvis portrait also on portrait paper for only $3. Those great Elvis buttons, $2 each. The 11x14 color photograph of Elvis for only $3. Beautiful posters suitable for framing in beautiful color for only $3 each. When everyone has a front row seat with a set of binoculars, we have those great binoculars for $5 each. And then we have two brand new Elvis super souvenirs. One is a beautiful Elvis necklace. All the ladies want to wear an Elvis necklace for only $5. And then in limited supply this evening, a beautiful Elvis gold belt buckle for $10. All at the Elvis Super Souvenir concession stands in the outer lobbies. The vendors are in the audience. You have plenty of time before this evening's concert begins to get your memento of your evening with Elvis and get one of the great Elvis Super Souvenirs.
I'd like to introduce you to Monique Brave from the Sioux Indian tribe here in Rapid City, and Mayor LaCroix, who's got a presentation for you also.
Elvis, on behalf of the citizens of Rapid City and the community, welcome to Rapid City, and we appreciate you being our first concert in our new auditorium.
Thank you.
And this says so on our plaque. It's for your grand opening concert here. Thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you.
And Monique?
Hi, Monique.
Hi. This is a medallion of life for you, Elvis, from the Sioux Nation.
Oh, that's lovely. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. We're here at the show.
Good luck to you, Elvis.
1, 2, 3, 4. I said she, she's your right. And then she,
thank you very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.